Another sign that the end is near, the U.S. removed the flag at its command in Baghdad today, symbolizing American military command in Iraq is officially over. What's left now is to withdraw the 4,000 remaining troops in the coming days.
No words, no ceremony can provide full tribute to the sacrifices that have brought this day to pass.
Processing, as they call it, takes days, sometimes even longer. So all the troops at this point can do is wait as America's biggest military mission since Vietnam comes to an end. Tonight we speak with a local Iraq war veteran who says he, even though the war is over, the United States' role in the Middle East certainly is not. Action News reporter Mei Chow is live in Monterey with that story for us.
Aaron, we sat down with Colonel Daniel Pate, Commandant at the Defense Language Institute, who was in Iraq in 2003 when the U.S. initial surge of that country began.
I was struck by a sense of sort of turning the page, and that, you know, there has been a tremendous cost and a tremendous price paid.
Colonel Daniel Pate, Commandant at the Defense Language Institute, says Thursday's news that the U.S. military officially ended its mission in Iraq represents a significant transition in our country's role in the Middle East.
It marks a significant transition in our role there from one of fighting a war to being partnered more with a sovereign Iraq.
Pick, who took part in the U.S. invasion of Iraq in 2003, says he and the country still have an enduring role in Iraq. He was part of a team which took down Saddam Hussein and helped put in place a democratic process.
Today, as we lower the flag and fully transition to an Iraqi lead, we can take, and we should take, a lot of pride in what we were able to do as the military there.
All U.S. troops are scheduled to leave Iraq by the end of the year, and senior U.S. military officials say they'll likely meet that goal, and the soldiers may even return home before then. Pick says even when the troops are gone, the U.S. will not abandon what it started.
When we started this in 2003, it was impossible to predict how it was going to unfold. And I think that We have reached a point that's very important where the Iraqis have made the decision to assert full sovereignty and to now begin to take care of their own security internally with assistance from us through our embassy.
The war left more than 4,500 Americans and more than 100,000 Iraqis dead. It also left 32,000 American troops wounded and drained nearly $800 billion from the U.S. Treasury. Erin.
All right, May, thank you. And during the course of the eight-year war, the Central Coast lost 8 members of the military, and to honor them, we want to state each one individually. It is Lieutenant Victor Gonzalez of Pajaro, Specialist Morgan Jacobs of Soquel, Corporal Andres Perez of Live Oak, Sergeant Robert Johnson of Seaside, Scotts Valley's Lance Corporal Joseph Spence, Staff Sergeant Jason Hendricks of Watsonville, Santa Cruz's Lieutenant Killen Jones Huffman, and Private George Howell of Prunedale.